让宝路美国午餐音乐现在开始。 America. Welcome to music of the 1950s, the 1960s, and the 1970s. First of all, thank you very much to our producers here in America, Mike and Maria. Could please have a round of applause for Mike and Maria. Thank you very much. Now, what about our translator? What is your name, please? It is wonderful to meet you. You do such a great job. Can we shake hands? Thank you very much. A big round of applause for our translator. Thank you very much. All right. We are back in the saddle again. We're going to have a fun show. We're going to get to some of your letters this week that you've written over the past several weeks. And thank you so much for that. Let's start off with the swinging medallions and a double shot to my baby's love.
Suspicious because she loved me so hard to find.
曙光出现，金光千里，原野新貌进入眼帘。这个就是万宝路的世界。
Letter time, we got a beautiful letter this week from Tiny. And Tiny says in the letter here, I also want to make friends all over the world, but now that's impossible. So I think when I grow up, I must be a famous person like Elvis Presley or be a person like you. Then I can get a lot of friends. Oh, Tiny, you have a lot of friends already. And just by this letter, see, everybody's hearing you're already famous. I mean, you see what I'm saying? I don't consider myself famous at all. I just love to play music on the radio. But Tiny tells us a story. She says, she was in on Thursday noon in her room listening to our program, and she says her instructor, who loves the symphony, walked into her room, and he said, oh, what are you doing? He asked in a loud voice. I'm listening to the music, I replied. What? You call this noise music? He surprised me. After all, my room was full of music. It was very strong. Before long, you gave us the piece of Elvis Presley's Are You Lonesome Tonight? He enjoyed it very much. Wonderful, he said as soon as the music stopped. Will you accept it, I asked. Of course, he answered at once. But the singer was the king of rock and roll, I said. Pop music is music too. The masterpiece also can widely spread. He realized this. Isn't that nice? Thank you so much, Tiny, for your letter. And I agree with your professor that this music is kind of like listening to a symphony. When you really think about it, Elvis Presley, that song you talked about in your letter. Thank you for your letter. God bless you. Here's Elvis with Are You Lonesome Tonight.
Are you lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry we drifted apart? Does your memory stray to a bright summer day when I kissed you and called you sweetheart? Do the chairs and your fire seem empty and bare? Do you gaze at your doorstep and picture me there? Is your heart still true? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight?
I wonder if you're lonesome tonight. You know, someone said that the world's a stage and you must play a part. They had me playing in love with you as my sweetheart. Act one was where we met. I loved you at first glance. You read your lines so cleverly and never missed a cue. And then came Act Two. Using the change, you acted strange. And why, I've never known. Honey, you lied when you said you loved me. And I have no cause to doubt. But I'd rather go on hearing your lies and to go on living without you. Now the stage is bare, and I'm standing there with emptiness all around.
and everyone come back to me, then they can bring the curtain down.
Is your heart still with me? Shall I come back? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight?
That is for Tiny. Thank you so much for your beautiful, inspiring letter. That was Presley, Are You Lonesome Tonight? Now, this is a different kind of rock and roll. As we go back to a song by a group called, they named themselves this. They named themselves the Trash Men. And they came up with a song about a surfing bird. A bird that goes out in the water and rides on surfboards. It doesn't make any sense to me either. I mean, what can I tell you? Here are the Trash Men. I think you'll like this song. It's called Surfing Bird.
Everybody knows that the bird is a whale, a whale, a bird, 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 a bird,
晚霞万丈，百鸟归巢。静听大自然美妙交响乐。这个就是万宝路的世界。
Letter just a couple of weeks ago, and by the way, I'm getting a little behind in my letter writing. Please forgive me. I will write to you as soon as I can. It just seems like time is so little right now. But we got a letter from YBDING. I hope that's pronounced Ding. I'm not going to try to pronounce it though, because I'll probably get it wrong. But in the letter, she says she was so excited to receive the gift. It was just a picture of Elvis. It's very kind of you. We showed the pictures to all the class. They were very, very much admired. In the pictures we see, I sent some pictures. Can we see your kids and your pretty wife? You are a lucky dog. Thank you very much. Your wife's chocolate cookies must be very delicious. Let me kind of explain that. See, as I was writing the letter, I ate a cookie, I was picking up a cookie, and then I grabbed the letter I was writing and accidentally got chocolate all over her. Poor, I'm so sorry about that. And then what happened was I went ahead and mailed the letter because I didn't want to write it over again, and she got chocolate, and I think she says, I ate some of the chocolate. No, I'm kidding. I'm just kidding about that. Believe it or not, it will be delicious. She's talking about the food she'll fix in China someday if I ever come over there. What else did she say here in the letter? She asked about Graceland, where Elvis Presley lived. Do many people go there? Have I been there? Yes, I have been to Graceland in Memphis, Tennessee, and there was a line about, five blocks long waiting to get in of people, so I said, maybe next time, and we were just passing through anyway, so we went on to Little Rock, Arkansas, we did. But that's the letter. Thank you so much for your wonderful letters. We'll give you our mailing address a little bit later on, and you don't have to write in English. You can write in Chinese. We have someone here who can translate. Let's move along now with a group called the Chiffons. Here's their song called One Fine Day. Run Faster gets to come to China and meet all the beautiful people. Doesn't really say that much.
Come on.
About my best friend, you gotta have a friend in Jesus to get to the spirit of this guy. Norman Greenbaum, number one song from 1970. We have more letters here, and what a beautiful letter. This one comes from Anne, and she says, "Dear Ron, I can't describe my happiness when I saw the big white envelope which post from you. I like your letter just as much as I like your program." You made my whole day by writing this letter, and I think Run Faster is really a good name, especially in the year of the horse. What's your opinion? I agree with you totally. I'm changing my name to Run Faster in the Year of the Horse. Although I can see the copies of your family's pictures, I know there's some pictures, not very clearly. I thank you for them. I think you have two lovely children. Thank you very much. And she also goes down here and says, except for Elvis, I also like the songs of the Beatles. I hope someday later I can hear a song called Yesterday from your program. Well, God bless you so much. And thank you very much for writing in. Here is your song by the Beatles. It's called Yesterday.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Love looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Suddenly, I'm not half the man I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Oh, yesterday, concerning me. Why she had to go, I don't know. She wouldn't say. I said, yesterday, love was such an easy game to play. I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Why did she have to go? I don't know. She wouldn't say. Such an easy game to play. I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Thank you.
been crying. Too many teardrops for one heart to carry on. You're gonna cry 96 tears. You're gonna cry 96 tears. You're gonna cry, 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 cry. You're gonna cry, 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 cry. 96 tears. Come on, let me hear you cry now.
Cheers from Question Mark and the Mysterians. Before I play the next song, let me tell you what I just thought of. If you took a little baby Chinese baby that was about 6 months old, and you put the little baby Chinese baby in the same crib with a little American baby who was about 6 months old, they would be able to talk to each other and understand what the other one was saying. One would say, and the other baby would go, so you see what I mean? They would not kind of know. This is mine. Can you want one of these? Okay, I'll take one. This next song is called The Baby Sittin' Boogie. It's done by Buzz Clifford. He followed his child around the house with a tape recorder and recorded little sounds his child was making. And so that's what you're going to hear on this song. And I bet, even though it's not in any language, it's in baby talk. I bet you'll know exactly what the baby is saying. Buzz Clifford, here's The Baby Sittin' Boogie.
My girl, baby, sits the sun on her rock. I come up to Jordan and we start to rock. He is a holy girl, my favorite boy. You know the
In a town in Texas called Temple, Texas. You'll probably see it on your maps here, right about in the middle of the state. And we were kind of from a poor family. We didn't have a whole lot. In fact, we didn't even have air conditioning or anything like that. So we'd leave the windows open at night, and from a long way off, in the middle of the night, you would hear this train many miles away coming down the railroad track. And you'd hear it as it passed from a few miles away, and then it would go on into the night. And that's always been a part of my memory, that train coming and going in the night. And there's a song that kind of reminds me of that train. It's called Love Train by the OJs. And it's a song about all the different nations. It mentions China, it mentions America, it mentions all of us. Just riding together on what's called the Love Train. Hope you enjoy it.
Come on.
A song about a love train in this world for the OJs. Now another train song, a group called The Impressions, and a song about the train that comes after that train. It's called People Get Ready.
Thank you.
Run Faster, I should say, with a song from way back in the late 1960s. Now, the man who sings this song, I must tell you, was not a great singer. And as he was singing the song, the man in the other booth listening to the recording said, that's not so good. So he went in the room and he said, just stay where you are. And he moved the microphone back some, like about right here. And so the guy sang the song again the next time. He said, no. And he moved the microphone down. He's way back here. He's almost screaming the words of the song. No one can hear. Well, he finally put him almost in the next room where you could barely hear what he was saying. They released a song like that, and it went all the way to number one because no one could figure out what he was saying. They were trying to figure out, what in the world is this man singing on this song? It must be something interesting. It's about a guy in a boat, really. Anyway, here's the group, the Kingsmen, the song Louie Louie, the song you cannot understand any of the words to, even if you do speak English.